Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. MashaAllah, tabarakallah, beautiful day here in Harare, Zimbabwe. We have a mashaAllah overcast weather, and I hope and pray that inshaAllah we will be receiving beneficial rain by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, a few very, very important messages, and inshaAllah I will take a moment to read your questions, perhaps your observations. And I just want to ask you something before I even start. I am taking suggestions from you for topics that you would like to see me discuss, inshallah, in my future programs and events, lectures, talks, and interactions, inshallah. So what I've done is, in the previous lectures and programs, events that I've had, every time we have a Q&A, we can only answer a certain number of questions. And I prefer to take the questions in writing for several reasons. One of the reasons is that what we would be able to do is read the questions that people have raised in order to address them perhaps on different platforms or on another occasion, in another lecture, at another event, or sometimes even share it with some of our colleagues in order to be able to address it. Perhaps a different person who might be a specialist in that particular field may address the matter. So it's very interesting how much of feedback we have from you. And what I would like to ask you today is to send me an email on muftimenk@gmail.com. Now, obviously, when you send an email to muftimenk@gmail.com, it goes straight to admin. And admin will reply and put forward to my attention that which is extremely important for me to address. Otherwise, it's responded to by admin. And sometimes, if it is a matter that is not urgent, or if we feel that there are other scholars who could deal with this matter closer to you, then we may choose to leave that, subhanAllah. At the same time, we do pray for everyone who sends us messages. We may not be able to read all those messages, but the minimum is we pray, oh Allah, alleviate the suffering of all those who are struggling and suffering, guide those who are searching for guidance, and so on. So these are beautiful prayers that would actually that would actually be part and parcel of the life of a mu'min and would be beneficial to every one of us. Okay, mashallah. Today I have something to share with you. I have a friend. And I'm sure we all have good friends. Some of them leave a mark. Some of them actually mean much more than others. But we have friends upon different levels, depending on what exactly the relationship is and how it has unfolded, why it is there. Usually, normally, those who are with you from childhood are the ones who would probably be with you for a longer period of time. Not necessarily. Sometimes we make the best of friends later on in life. Sometimes we're let down by our friends. Now, I want to share with you something very interesting. When you have a friend, you do not become so close to them that you share with them information that no one is supposed to be knowing besides you. Because one day when you break up, they will really have too much of information about you. They will basically hold you at ransom. You need to know this. So therefore, it is a narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some of the scholars say it may have stopped at the Sahaba, at the Sahabi. Some take it right to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But however, it is brilliant advice, stating that when you love someone, love them in moderation, which means you need to know the limits. You know, one day you may not be friends again. One day they may be your enemy. And the same applies when you dislike someone. You make sure that you dislike them in moderation. Don't do things that will create such a big embarrassment that the day you become friends, which is very possible for the Almighty, you will be embarrassed about what you did to them, or you will have hurt them a little bit much. So that's my piece of advice for today. And inshallah, I will be sharing more advice later on today. Let's speak about this a little bit. So I have a friend, mashallah, very close. They've helped me, maybe. This is just an example. They've helped me financially. They might have helped me get a place in school. They might have helped me during my school days, in my business, with my family. They might have helped me in so many different ways. Does it mean that I must lower my guard, tell them every detail about my life, where I've sinned, how I've sinned? Remember, my brothers and sisters, when you share your sins with others, it's actually another sin. when you share your sins with others, it becomes another sin. The reason is, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Allah says, those who like to share the stories and tales of immorality with others, they will be served a severe punishment because you drop the level of morality. Imagine everyone goes and describe how they committed a sin. If you're teaching someone a lesson and you're saying, you know, we're all sinful people, we've all done things that we're not happy about, we're not proud of, you know, we've changed. Recently, I watched a clip on Brother Mike Tyson. I'm sure you guys would know who Brother Mike Tyson is. And there was an interview where someone who was asking him the questions, the interviewer, was actually asking him about something way back. And he said, hey, listen, that was when I was 19, 20. I don't know what your aim is in asking me these questions, where you want this interview to go. But now I'm 43, and this was like 10 years ago. He says, now I'm 43, and I really, really don't want to be the, you know, the person I was. It's past. It's long. We've all changed. You've changed. I've changed. And wallahi, that's a fact. When we're young, sometimes we do things. As you grow older, you mature, you become a better person, you become more tolerant, you have your own children, you become a patient person. And may Allah bless those who don't have children with children. Ameen. So basically what would happen is we would all change. We all have changed over time. It's not good enough for someone to keep harping about your past, about something you might have done when you were 15, 18, 19, 25, you know, 28, and go all the way back. When your life has changed, you've contributed to humanity. Everything has changed. You've contributed in a positive way to society, to your family. You've become a beautiful person. The people around you actually love you as you are today, not as you were before. Don't let your past bog you down, but we should never bog people down based on their past. What that means is don't hold a person's past way back against them. If it is fresh and they have not changed their ways and habits, by all means, you may want to say this was the case since you were young. You have not changed. But if you see a change, if you witness a person having changed, having really developed themselves, you need to learn from what Brother Mike Tyson said the other day. Sorry, it was an interview that I watched the other day, but the statement was 10 years back. Words of wisdom, honestly. And I've seen when we were young, he was the hero. Well, not to say he's much older than I am, but at the same time, I've seen some of his fights. He was a champion, a person I've never, ever seen. To this day, I've never, ever seen boxers who would actually catch my attention, so fiery and so, you know, fired up, and the attack was so unique. When it comes to Mike Tyson, he's the guy who's saying, hey, that was me a long time back. Stop asking me about and bringing up things that were a long time back. Now let's go back to what we were saying. So if, for example, you have something that you had done in the past that was not good and you shared it with your friends, one day when you're no longer a friend of that person, and that can happen, it has happened to almost all of us, where you've got a bosom buddy, a person who's very close to you, Allah takes them away to show you that the one who you're supposed to be the closest to is the Almighty. He alone will not let you down. The rest of the people can let you down. So when you get too close to people, sometimes the Almighty, you know, puts a crack there to say, hey, You got to know where your allegiance lies. You know, each one is for himself in the hereafter. But here, as much as we've given you friendship, you got to know your limits. So if you shared all your sins and everything and every detail of your business and how you operate your business and what you deal in, who your suppliers are, where you work and how you got the job and how much your salary is and every detail of what your wife does and what your husband does and what your family members do and so on, that will be detrimental for your future, your well-being, the day that you break up with that person. I promise you, it is a powerful piece of advice. My brothers and sisters, this is something we all need to learn from. And because human beings are such that, you know, your heart opens up to someone, you feel so close to them. I've learned something very dangerous these days. You have people who are recording private discussions, and sometimes they mean well, sometimes they don't mean well. But when I see a person with a phone in their pocket and, you know, the little camera is actually this way, you know, is facing the people, I always say, I hope you're not recording, you know. Because if it's a private discussion, I mean, if I'm busy eating, imagine with these braces, it's not quite simple to eat. You know, you look like you're struggling to chew, and you wouldn't like that image to actually come out in the public and everyone sees that, oh, you've been eating and you look so greedy and so on. And, you know, hey, let's learn to be people who are sincere and genuine. And we need to also have friends who will actually respect us. We need to have friends who will respect us. If you hang on a second, I can just ask someone to close the door because someone's working at the back there. Shukran. So it's beautiful where we have limitations, limits. When you tell someone, tell them a limited amount. When you share your happiness, make sure that you share it in a way that you do not give too much of information. You will lose your job. I promise you, your business partners will actually be stolen, or something might happen. They might get to someone. People are not all sincere. Sometimes your best friends become your enemies. Like I said, it's happened to almost all of us. If not every one of us, maybe not your best friend, but a lot of people who were close to us, as time passes, there is a gap that happens. Sometimes it's legitimately because we're busy, because we're far away, we still love each other. You know, sometimes distance actually makes the heart grow fonder, indeed. But I'm talking of a different type of a distance. The distance where you now no longer care for each other, you now no longer, get along with each other, like each other, no more, because of some misunderstandings that have happened, and sometimes it's irreconcilable. It happens with people who are married. Imagine, married. You marry someone you absolutely love. You ended up loving them, etc. And one day something happens, and what do you know? The next thing is divorced. Divorce is permissible. It's one. It's the worst thing that could happen, but it's permissible. So now, what you need to know is, when you've given too much of information and when you've been too close where every movement of yours is known, trust me, you've just shot yourself in the foot. That's what you've done. That's what you've done. Now, this is a powerful piece of advice. The opposite of it is also correct. The opposite of it is also correct. What is it? When you dislike someone, be careful. I see a lot of people swearing sometimes. You know, they could be belonging to a different sect. They could be, I belong to Islam. I'm a Muslim. But I'm a human being as well. So I belong to humanity and I belong to Islam. So I care for my Muslim brothers and sisters, and I care for humanity and human beings as well. So much so that I'm a creature of the Almighty, and I care for the creatures that Almighty who made me has created, because that's my link with Him. I respect everything He's done, and I respect everyone He has made and everything that He has made. That's who I am. But now you find some people who don't understand. So they decide, because I think this way, because I belong to this particular religion, this particular sect, etc., etc., then I've got to say these hurtful, nasty words, and you know, I've got to be derogatory. As soon as I see someone with a beard, for example, I've got to start calling him a terrorist. As soon as I see someone with a niqab or a hijab, I've got to call them a derogatory term. Excuse them. You know why? Because, like I've said before, they hate you and their hatred has no limits to it. So it will go beyond the limit. It does happen with some Muslims as well, where hatred goes beyond the limit. I've seen it even with people of different sects. For example, people who disagree with you on one matter. You know, recently there was something that happened. People asked me a question. I'll give you an example. The ruling of cryptocurrency. What is it? Now, to be honest with you, there are two opinions. One says it's okay. One says it's not okay. In a nutshell, you do not hate on each other. I heard someone say, oh, if this guy says it's okay, then that's the end of my relationship with him. What a fool. Subhanallah. What a fool. How small-minded is that? Because actually what has happened in that particular case would be, whatever the millions of points of benefit you could have benefited from a man, you've just discounted them completely because of one difference that you've had. And the man didn't even say that. And on top of that, even if he did, what if he's right and you're wrong? So my brothers and sisters, this is something amazing. Now, I've got to tell you something. It might surprise you. But anyway, I have to go to buy some groceries, subhanAllah. So the time is up, it's 12 o'clock. I need to get there before lunchtime, inshallah. So as much as I love you, I have to leave you, because you know what? Family comes first. So guys, I have a chore. People are waiting for me. I've got to accompany my family to buy a bit of a few things. And the reason I'm just sharing this with you is, you know, people are waiting here for me. And family comes first. So goodbye, everyone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.